Hello and welcome. From the 2023.2 Typhoon HIL Control Center software release, dual active bridge and resonant converter components are further improved, achieving a 25 nanosecond simulation time step and a specially provided firmware configuration on 4th generation HIL404 and HIL606 devices. State calculations of these components are done every 25 nanoseconds. Since the minimum simulation time step for currently available HIL devices is 200 nanoseconds, these state values are then averaged over the course of each simulation time step and reported on the component's outputs in order to stay consistent with the rest of the real-time model. From the component outputs, you can observe only these average values. In addition, dual active bridge and resonant converter components are now available on 3rd generation HIL602 Plus and HIL604 devices with a time step of 50 nanoseconds. Let's see where to find these components. We can find the improved resonant converter and dual active bridge components in Schematic Editor by navigating to the Converter's Library category, Enhanced Resolution subfolder. The required parameters for the components remain the same as for previous software releases. In this video, we will use the dual active bridge component to verify controller behavior in an emulated environment. This circuit contains a dual active bridge bidirectional converter and a battery connected on each side of the power converter. The dual active bridge allows energy exchange between the batteries. Current and voltage signals are filtered by input and output LC filters. A TI launchpad F2A3790 is connected to a HIL404 device via HIL TI launchpad interface board to form a C-HIL setup. A microcontroller mounted on the TI launchpad runs the control code and provides gate drive signals for the switches inside the dual active bridge converter. The current measurement I2 is sent from the HIL device to the controller via analog output 4 as a feedback value for closed loop current regulation. Now, let's compile the model and load it to a HIL404 device. Communication between HIL-SCADA and the microcontroller is handled using serial communication protocol through a serial communication widget. The control principle allows regulation of the power flow direction in three operational modes: open loop mode, charging, and discharging battery two. Let's set the current reference to 80 ampere and the operational mode to charge battery two. You can see that the controller matches the actual battery current value to the reference value since this is a closed loop control mode. In the capture scope widget, you can observe current and voltage waveforms along with gate drive signals provided on HIL digital input pins 1 and 3. Let's capture the signals and zoom in. We can see that PWM switching period is 5 microseconds, which means that microcontroller is driving the switches with a 200 kHz. Thanks to the 25 nanosecond solver, you can more accurately simulate dual active bridge converters even if they are driven at such high PWM frequencies. We hope that these enhanced dual active bridge and resonant converter components will help you develop high frequency charging applications. Thank you for watching.
Check the video description for more resources on this topic, including how to download and get started with Typhoon HIL Control Center for free. You can also visit HIL.academy to access free courses, expand your HIL testing skill set, and get certified. Subscribe to our channel to get notified about new content.